Let me ask you a quick question. How do you currently set up deals in your WooCommerce store? Well, let me tell you. You go to each and every product page, edit it, add the sale price, schedule the sale, so basically add the start date and the end date. Right? Even in case of a category-wide sale, well, you have to visit each and every product page of that specific category to set up the sale. Now think about this. In case of an ongoing promotion, let's say you want to promote during the Black Friday or you want to set up a Christmas special sale, the process of setting up a sale is so tedious and so time-consuming that, well, you much rather give it up. I know the drill and I get it. Hi, I'm Tavleen from Excel Plugins, and in this video, I'm going to show you the most hassle-free way to set up deals in your WooCommerce store. Also, I will show you how to list all those deals on a single page. So this is how Amazon does it. When you click on today's deal in the navigation bar, you are led to this page which lists all the deals one below the other. ThingGeek does it too. Well, it beautifully shows all the deals on a single page. And now you can do it too in your WooCommerce store. So people will be able to click on the link in the navigation bar or on the button on the sticky header, and they will be directed to the single page which lists all your discounted items together. Sounds like a great plan, doesn't it? Well, of course it does. So let me show you how you can do this in your WooCommerce store right away. Let's get behind the scenes and let me show you how to set this up. All right, so here we are logged into the backend of WooCommerce. I'm sure that you're familiar with that. Now let us go on to Excel plugins and then move on to Finale. All right, so what we're going to do is we're going to just simply go and hit add new campaign, and we will be directed to a page where we can add a new campaign. So you can name this campaign. Let us say I'm going to call it discount of 5% on music category products under $100, right? So what I'm doing is that I want to apply a discount of 5% on products in music category. And here's the thing, not all products in music category, but only products which are priced under $100. Well, so that is my condition. Right now I'm going to schedule the campaign. So simply select the start date and time and end date and time to schedule your campaign. Then moving on to discount, so I want to give a discount of 5%, right? So it's a basic discount in percentage of 5%. Now, we're going to go on into the rule builder. As you can notice, that always is what is selected as default. So we will go to product category, and in product category, we will select music here. In addition to that, we will say when the product price is less than $100, right? And this is how we want the campaign to be. So we want the campaign to only run on products which are in the music category, and they should be priced under $100, right? So these are our two conditions. Now, once we've done that, we're going to simply go and publish this. As you can notice, you've got a lot of other options. This is for inventory, coupons, elements, and a lot of other things for setting up sticky header, sticky footer, and all of that. But we're not going to go into that at the moment. Right now, simply just two things: scheduling a campaign that should start on a set date and time, and giving a discount of 5%, right? So you hit publish with that, and once you hit publish, the campaign has now been created. We're now going to go and head over to Excel plugins Finale deal pages. Now Finale deal pages gives you two options, which is of indexing the campaign, right, and creating a short code. Now, indexing the campaign, obviously, it means that it will allow you to show all the products on which the deal is going on the same page, right? So now, it would have otherwise had to pick those products, and the load time of the pages would be really high because it's having to pick those products and place it there. But now with index campaigns, we are indexing all the products which are in that particular, which are part of that particular deal at once, right? So it's not going to be very query intensive, and it's going to quickly load all the products which are part of that deal in a matter of few seconds, right? So we're going to go and index this campaign. So index campaign and deal page short codes are actually two features which are part of Finale deal pages. They're a separate module, which is an add-on module on top of Finale, right? All right, so now the campaign is getting indexed. Now, once the campaign has been indexed, you have to generate a new short code, right? Now, what is basically this doing is that when you generate a new short code, it will, when you are done configuring all this, you will get a short code, right? And this short code, you can paste it on a new page with a headline. And that short code is what will allow you to display all the deals on a single page which have been indexed as a part of this campaign. So step one is to choose your campaign. So this is what the campaign that we're talking about at the moment, discount of 5% in music category on products under $100. So here you can just enter a title. We can say the same thing, discount of 5% on music category. All right, so this is what is happening. Now we will go on to template. Template is basically the format in which you would like to display your campaigns. You've got two options here, grid and list. Grid, in grid you've got again two options, three column or four column, right? So here is how that single isolated unit will appear. Now when you say three columns, it'll obviously be in three different columns, and this unit will be appearing in three different columns. But this is how the product will essentially appear on the deal page, right? I will show you the list format. So we will select list format at the moment and go with that. Then you've got the option for setting up the countdown timer. Again, this is when you want to show that it is a time limited deal and you want a countdown timer to be running on the deal page as well, right? So you can also hide it if you do not want the countdown timer to be running on the deal pages. Again, you have the option to choose different skins. So you've got a few skins here for your countdown timer. You can select any of these, right? Then you've got the background, label, color, and all of that. You've got the timer labels here, days, hours, minutes, and all of that. So I'm just going to leave it at that, and then I'm going to publish, and I'm going to show you how it appears on the front end. All right, so now our short code has been generated. So we're going to copy this and we're going to go on to pages, and we're going to create right, so let's just create a new page here. Now I've copied the short code, and I'm going to paste the short code over here, and I'm going to say that sale on music category, right? So here we are, this is the list format, and this is how the deals are appearing one below the other, and this is specifically on the music category on products which are priced under $100, and this is the deal page which is showing us all the deals. In addition to that, we could also say something like, so we could say count is equal to, let's say 3, and we could also say pagination. And we can also say pagination is equal to yes, right? So count is equal to 3 and pagination is equal to yes. And then we're going to update this. So based on the command that we set, it is showing us 3 products on this page, and the pagination has been turned on. So even the second page has 3 products, right? So it has divided each page of 3 products, right? And the pagination has been turned on, right? So this is what this command, this little command here, has done. Now let me show you some stuff that I quickly brushed over so I can come back to it later, right? So let me just show you some other options related to appearance. In appearance, you've got a lot of options to configure the appearance of this particular page, right? Now it asks you what action, what message would you like to show when the campaign has expired. So you can set the message here based on what you would like to show. Then you've got the add to cart button color. Here, as you can notice, we've got this bright orange color. You're most welcome to change the color based on your theme. You can change the text color, the text font size. Right now the text color is white and the font size is 18. You're most welcome to change that. Then you've got the pagination. As you can notice, in pagination we've got this blue and these circles. You're most welcome to change it to square, and you can change the colors here from blue to anything that you like, right? This is the sale batch color. Here is the sale batch. Now this is bright orange in color, or I should say actually dull orange in color. So you can change that batch as well to something else that you like based on, again, or your theme, right? And then hide on grid. If you would like to hide the description, rating, or sales batch, you're most welcome to do that. At the moment, we've got the description, rating, and sales batch, all 3 of these turned on, right? So we haven't hidden any one of these 3. Then the product description length. So if you would like this to be capped at 200, which is what we've done right now, you can always cap it at 200, right? Let me show you the other format as well. So we're going to go into template, and we're going to turn on the grid format, which is 3 columns. Alright, so here we are. This is how the grid format will come up, right? As you can notice, all the products are listed are in a three column format, and here's the pagination, because we've already said that don't show more than three products on a single page. So that is exactly what it is doing over here. We've got more options here. You can also show the inventory bar to show the number of units left in stock, and they will be visible right here, right? So the inventory bar will come up right here. If you want, you can have the timer, or you can do away with the countdown timer. You can also change the skins based on what you like, right? Right now we've got this simple one. You can change it to different options. You've got different skin options over here for the appearance of countdown timer on the deal page here. So extremely useful option. Well, that's it really. So we created finale deal pages because a lot of store owners came to us and they said that they wanted the option to show their different deals and promotions on a single page, but so that the shoppers can come and all they have to do is that they have to click on a link in the navigation bar or a button on the sticky header, and they will be simply directed to this page which contains all their deals listed on one page, right? So if you're running a Christmas special offer or a Black Friday deal, all your Black Friday discounted items, all your Christmas special discounts can come together on a single page. Incredibly useful option, and I really hope that you learned a lot from this video and you enjoyed watching this video. I would highly recommend that you click on the link in the description box below, which contains a blog post. So whatever I taught you in this video has been put together in a blog post, so that you can refer back to it whenever you like. And yeah, that's it. Get ready to change your game with Finale Deal Pages, and really I wish you lots of sales during this promotion season. Thank you so much for watching. Do not forget to subscribe to this channel, like and comment on this video. You know the drill. Thank you so much for watching. I'll see you next time. Till then, happy selling.